As of March 2nd of 2025, there are currently 45 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 4 less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Nicaragua's Masaya volcano, which long ago was searched by conquistadors who incorrectly thought that gold lied buried within its active lava lake. While they, of course, did not find any gold, it is a reminder that this volcano has maintained an active lava lake for much of the last 500 years at a minimum. While its current eruption is almost completely effusive, albeit with some occasional minor ash emissions, the presence of a caldera indicates that thousands of years ago, Masaya produced far more powerful and explosive eruptions. And now, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. In Hawaii, the Kilauea Shield volcano erupted once again, this time producing a series of up to 600-foot-tall lava fountains. Meanwhile, in Iceland, magma is building towards the next eruption of the Reykjanes volcano north-northeast of Grindavík, which one model suggests is most likely to begin between March 9th and March 11th. And, in what is this week's top story, which happens to be largely overlooked, a lava flow in the Democratic Republic of the Congo is advancing towards a populated area which has not been inundated by lava flows in multiple generations. This is occurring at Nyamuragira, a highly active shield volcano north-northwest of the major city of Goma. As you can see by the abundant lava flows on its flanks, Nyamuragira frequently emplaces alkali-rich tephrite lava, albeit primarily from two rift zones which run through the volcano. As a result, the hundreds of lava flows emplaced here during the last two centuries have almost solely followed one of four pathways, aided in part by local topography. In turn, this means that a fairly sizable area to Nyamuragira's west-southwest and east-northeast have been almost completely untouched by destructive eruptions for centuries. While the eastern section is completely unpopulated, our problem arises due to the fact that the western section is indeed populated by around 2,000 people. And, possibly due to topographic changes in Nyamuragira's summit caldera, for the first time in its recorded history, lava flows have been repeatedly traveling further and further down west into populated areas. This first occurred between May and July of 2023, and then again from August to September of 2024. This is now occurring for a third time, specifically since January 18th of 2025. This lava flow has traveled 5.1 kilometers or 3.17 miles since then and is still continuing to advance at the present. While less likely, the current lava flow has the potential to travel as much as 9 kilometers away in my opinion, which could place these clusters of structures and homes at risk. In Hawaii, on February 25th of 2025 at 6:26 p.m. local time, the famed Kilauea volcano erupted once again, marking its 11th eruptive episode since December 23rd. This began with weak lava effusion from its northern vent, but soon this gave way to increasingly tall lava fountains which by 6:50 had grown to become 200 feet tall. Another 60 minutes later, lava fountains reached their peak height as they rose 600 feet or 183 meters into the air. Some of the lightweight ejecta fell beyond the caldera rim, depositing these lava clasts. Afterwards, eruptive activity declined at both vents until the northern vent ceased erupting the following day at 6:35 a.m., with the southern vent following 31 minutes later. More eruptive episodes are expected to occur at the shield volcano in the following days to weeks, with the next one expected to occur before or on March 4th to March 6th. Meanwhile, in Iceland, it has been 83 days since the last eruption of the Reykjanes volcano, and its underlying shallow magma chamber has already surpassed the minimum volume required to trigger an eruption. As a result of this continued magma accumulation, molten rock is expected to propagate eastwards and erupt via a fissure 5.5 kilometers north-northeast of the town of Grindavík. While an eruption still might technically not happen, a similar volume eruption to the previous one is expected to begin on or around March 9th to March 11th of 2025 per one scientific model. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on March 1st of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, MindZ, for supporting my work.